What if I told you that you can take anything in your craft stash and turn it into a stamp? And what if I told you that all you need for that is a $5 tool? The tool I'm talking about is the Simon Hurley stamping foam, and I tried it for the first time for this video and I find it really cool. This is basically a very dense foam block and you get 4 in a pack, so this should give you quite some mileage for $5. The awesome feature of this tool is that when the foam is heated up, it becomes moldable. So if you press anything into it, you will be able to transfer the impression onto the foam. All you need to do next is to ink it up and use it as a stamp. For a more watercolor-like look, you can spritz the foam with some water before doing your stamping, and I think the result is really pretty. You can stamp this directly on your card front and you would have a nice border all around, but honestly, I will never get this straight and I know that this would really bother me. So I'd rather die-cut my backgrounds and use those inside my card designs. Like I did with this shaker card, for example, that I created with some Heffy Doodle frame dies and some MFT stamps. Cleaning up the foam if you use water-based inks is really easy. You just need to spritz it with some water and then wipe off the excess with a microfiber cloth. To restore the surface back to its original state, you need to heat it up again and it will go flat again. This is like magic, it's so fun! I showed you how you can use background stamps and get sort of the negative impression, but you can use any stamp set really. Here I'm using the smaller images in the Life is Good stamp set by Lon Fon, and honestly I was so surprised with how much I loved the result. So much so that I included it in a summer scene card that I created with the Lon Fon on the beach stamp set, and I think that this background really adds a fun and unique touch to the card. Another fun thing you can do is to turn your stencils into stamps. Just make sure you apply some nice pressure all over the surface of the foam and then you can go ahead and create your backgrounds. Here I did some repeated stamping because I wanted to show you that there is some flexibility with these backgrounds. In this case, for example, I used it for a slimline shaker card and I think the result is really cute and really fun. So you're not limited to A2 cards. You can also use your foam with embossing folders, which are making a comeback these days. And the good thing with embossing folders is that you can get both the debossed and embossed side, and you see everything in your craft room is getting another use. And I find this really exciting, and I think it's a great way to give some life back to those older supplies that we maybe don't feel as inspired to use anymore. And by no means are you limited to craft supplies. See this background here? I created it with my chamois holder. And because the foam will retain its shape until you heat it up again, I was able to come back the day after and use this same impression on an art journal page. I stamped it on a background that I had created with some distress ink sprays, and then I finished up my page with some brayering, and I clearly don't know what I'm doing here. A little bit of stenciling and this huge rainbow from a recent release by Colorado Craft Company. And this is really cool because, if I'm honest, I was a little bit concerned about the size of the foam as I felt that it would be a little bit limiting in terms of designs. But hey, I was wrong and I'm happy I was. Oh, by the way, I was almost forgetting cover dies. Of course you can turn them into stamps too, and look how cute this starry background looks in a night scene card. Speaking of cover dies, I have a video right here where I try to explore different ways to use them to see if we can really make them worth the money, cause those guys, they're not cheap. So click here to find out and I'll meet you there.